The B wave usually, as we mentioned, it is repolarization of the atria. You should know is this B wave it originated from the SA node or from the other focus. You should know from where this B wave come from. If it is coming from the sinus, usually we'll find it usually upright, يعني positive, and this a B wave usually positive lead the inferior leads usually lead 2 and lead 3 and AVF. Sometimes lead 3 we can't judge about the lead 2, but B wave, but the most important leads is lead 2. You should concentrate regarding the B wave on the lead 2, looking for the B wave shape and any abnormality. It is up or down, or it is there is bifid or beak. And also look for the V1 to look for if it is biphasic or upright or mainly negative. It reflects some abnormalities. So B wave, main leads to look for lead 2 and B1. Usually, if you find there is negative in lead 1, you should think of something abnormal. The most important things, you are putting the lead in wrong place. So the heart is registered upside down. So incorrect lead placement. The next step is to change, to repeat the ECG recording. Or there is the dextrocardia. We'll see some examples. Or there is ectopic atrial focus. There is some pacemaker other than SA node is firing either from the right atrium or from the left atrium. After the B wave, as we know, there is an interval called BR interval. Okay? And after the BR interval, there is QRS complex and then ST segment and then T wave. My question, what is the difference between the interval and the segment? When we can say this is BR segment, when we can say this is BR interval. Anyone can answer me? Harry, please. It is interactive session, Shabab. Anyone? Okay. The BR interval and the BR segment. The difference between the segment and the interval is the following. Usually the interval usually including the waves. But the segment is usually between the waves. For example, when we say ST segment means the part between the S and the T, not including the S and not including the T. ST interval is including S and V and T. For example, BR segment, which is the part from the between the B and the R. When we say this is a BR interval from the beginning of the B to the beginning of the R, this is the difference between the interval and the segment. So the BR interval, usually it is reflect the conduction, as we mentioned, the conduction from the SA node, atria, then AV node, and then bundle of Hess. And usually it is represent atrial depolarization plus conduction to the a delay in the AV junction. I have question, why there is a physiological delay in the AV node? Why there is here they mentioned there is delay in the AV junction and AV node. Why if in each atrial contraction there is a physiological delay in the AV node? Why not conducted immediately ventricle. Why not? This is very simple stuff. This is very basic. Can anyone tell me?
To allow the feeling of the blood.
Who's this?
To allow the feeling of the blood. يعني عشان يكون في زمن لل feeling of the blood عشان ما يحصل ال next contraction.
Excellent. What's your name?
My name is Habab Muhammad.
Excellent, excellent, Habab. Yes, you are right. Because it's allowed to the atria to empty and the ventricle to fill. If each atrial depolarization conducted immediately, there will not be a filling. So allow the filling, the ventricle to fill from the atrial contraction. So the VR interval represent this area, which is atrial depolarization plus delay in the AV junction. And usually the normal interval, when you read the ECG, you should check the VR interval. Check it from where? From the beginning of the B to the beginning of the R. Usually the normal from the 3 to 5 small square. 3 to 5 small square. If it is less than 3, we call it short BR interval. If it is more than 5, call it prolonged BR interval. Okay. What are the common syndrome cause short BR interval, ya shabab? Can anyone tell me?
WBW.
Yes. What is the meaning of that? What is the abbreviation for? It's abbreviation for
Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome.
So Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome, it is one of the causes of short VR interval. Excellent. And what are the, give me a cause for the prolonged VR interval.
Prolonged?
Yeah. Heart block, ahsanti. It's very either first degree or secondary. We'll discuss it in the arrhythmia session. Very interesting session. I like arrhythmia because it is difficult for everybody, but we'll make it very simple, inshallah. So this is that. So this is the BR interval. Okay. The second wave is QRS complex. Usually, the QRS complex, as you see here, from the QRS, it's huge. Usually, it is less than 11 milliseconds. يعني تقريبا 2 to 2.5 small square. If it is more than this, نسميها wide QRS complex. Or broad QRS complex, okay, and there is causes which is widening of the QRS complex. There is problem in the ventricular depolarization. There is something interrupting the smooth conduction to the ventricle, make it either very broad, and this is could be from the left ventricle, left vesicle, or left bundle, or from the right bundle. طيب the Q wave, if you it is the initial negative deflection. If you look here, this is small negative deflection. The initial negative deflection after the B wave is called Q wave, and not every Q wave abnormal. There is some abnormality. Okay. في حيث ما سب الكومبلكس فيها Q wave يسموها septal depolarization. We'll talk it later, يعني. لكن usually it is normally it is in the lateral lead with small Q wave. This is the normal. We'll discuss it later, inshallah. طيب. So when we can say this is the Q wave, it is not pathological. When we can say this is pathological, if it is less than small square, small, يعني it is small less than small square in the depth, and in the width less than one small square. we can call this non-pathological QA. يعني doesn't mean anything. But if it is more than two small square in the depth and the, in the width more than one small square or in the other يعني meaning by it is more than 25% of amplitude of corresponding R, this is a pathological QA. It reflects meaning. Usually in the V1, from the V1 to V6, there is a smooth progression. There is transitional leads. In the V1, usually there is a small R and large or deep S. Faster in the V6. V6, small Q and huge R. This is the normal. And usually start the QR complex progression started from the small R in the V1, then a little bigger in the V2, and then transition in V3 to con at least the R and S a little bit equal each other, and then transition mainly positive in the four, five, and six. This is a normal progression of the QRS complex. What about the ST segment? As we mentioned, the segment between the waves. So ST segment means the part of the ECG which is between the S and the T. Usually it is after the G point. Sorry. So the point, the G point usually is a part of the ECG which is after the ST, S wave. So the ST started from G point to the beginning of the T. Sometimes you will find a huge T and you can say this is oh my God, this is ST, this is ST segment elevation. No, this is not ST segment elevation. You should concentrate where is the elevation exactly, and where is the reference point. We'll talk about this in the ischemia session. And then after that, the T wave. The QT, which is interval, as intervals they قلنا, from the beginning of the Q to T, including this QT, very important. It is once it's prolonged, it reflects the patient is taking something or there is congenital syndrome leading to the prolongation of QT interval. And usually it is up to 440. If it is more than this, usually reflect a prolonged QT interval. SA node, usually the dominant maker of the heart, which is firing from 60 to 100. AV node, usually the backup. If the SA node fatigue, the AV node which will fire, will usually the limitation of the firing of the AV node from 40 to 60. And then the ventricle, subhanAllah, has ability to fire, which is backup for the intrinsic rate haga from 20 to 45 beat per minute. Before to this is first half of our session. We'll go now to the second half of our session. I will give you just 3 minutes to organize the to collect yourself, and if there's any question about the first part of the session, and then we'll continue to the second part of the session. I will just give you 3 minutes to review, and if you have any question, I can go back. Then I will continue to the interesting part of the session, which is the second part.
أي سؤال يا شباب؟
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته يا بص.
عليكم
السلام
السلام ورحمة
عليكم.
الله.
الله
مرحبا.
يسلمك. انت يا بص قلت انه الكيو ويفز دي بتتلاقي في كل ال في كل الليد صح؟
Yeah, it is usually in normal situation, usually we'll find it in the lateral leads. And I will tell you why we'll not find you just the lateral leads. When we'll bundle branch block. When we
تمام.
talk
طيب
about
يعني...
the bundle branch block, yeah,
طيب.
I will explain
طيب. الـ
to you
QT.
Why just this, yeah.
طيب في حالة عدم في حالة عدم وجود الكيو معناه ما في في اللحظة دي حيكون كيو تي انترفال رايت؟
No, you can imagine this is from the beginning of the R from the chorus complex. Usually, يعني you will find some tiny deflection. You will not يعني find يعني absolutely at least you will a little tiny negative deflection and you can start from there and usually the QT interval very challenging to measure. We'll talk about this in the arrhythmia session, but I will tell you which important leads you should measure the QT from, because not every lead is able to measure the QT interval. Excellent question, amazing question.
شكرا يا بوس.
Welcome. Any more question? Okay, can proceed or you can a little bit? Can we proceed or wait? Okay, if you look, this is this few slides is just summarizing the previous slide. There is 10 rules for the normal ECG. The first rule, and please, no need to memorize this. No need to memorize all of these things. It is will come with the time, with time. My slide is clear for everybody, because I'm not sure it is clear for everybody. I don't know.
It is clear, يا بوس. بس الصوت شوية كان قطع بس السجا.
Okay. Let us continue. These rules, not necessary to revise it, but will come with the time. As we know, the BR interval is usually from 120 milliseconds to 200 millisecond, which usually from 3 small square to 5 small square. This is the normal things. This is rule number one. No, rule number two, the QRS complex will not exceed 2.5 small square, maximally 3 small square. More than this, we call it wide QRS complex. Rule three, usually in the normal ECG, the QRS complex should be dominantly upright in the lead one and lead, as you see here. Usually upright. In the normal ECG, you should have a the same direction. The QRS complex and E wave usually in the same direction in the limb leads. اللي هي في lead one, lead two, lead three, AVL, AVF, and AVR. Usually in normal ECG, we'll find if the QRS complex positive, the T wave positive, and vice versa. Usually on the same line. The most important rule, which is rule five, all leads, all waves of the AVR are negative. بتلاقي ال B negative, ال QRS complex negative, a T wave negative. All of the waves of the AVR are negative, which is important rule. If you find something positive, there is something wrong going on. You should review your ECG and review your patient. We'll see some ECG. As we mentioned before, if there is any, the R wave progression should be started from the V1 to V6. Should be started growing up from small VR in the V1 to the biggest R in the V6. And the ST segment should be isoelectric, يعني within the horizontal line, except in the V1 and V2. Sometimes we'll find it elevated. Sometimes, في اليانجز كده, when you do the ECG, especially in the male, بتلاقي a little bit, the ST segment, a little bit شوية elevated. And you will be very worried about the patient. And this is yes, ST segment in MI, and you will يعني raise the red flag, and this is STEMI, and we should intervene. And the patient is calm and comfortable because this is what we call it is a male pattern ST segment elevation, because in the ST segment should be isoelectric. إلا في النورمال ممكن تلاقيها في V1 V2 a little bit elevated. We'll see some examples later. The B wave usually, as we mentioned before, it is upright in lead two and biphasic in V2 and V1. And the Q wave, as Dr. Alo, اللي سألتني على Q wave, and there I should know Q wave or only small tiny Q less than 0.04 millisecond. We usually تلاقيها في lateral lead and sometimes the rule 10, usually the T wave must be upright for lead 2 and lead 1 and lead 2 and for limb leads B2 to B6. Usually these rules not necessarily to memorize it, but will be your habit with every ECG you see. You will adapt yourself about these rules. This is just collection about the previous slides. Now we'll start with the talk of today is how you read the ECG. As you see, the ECG is 12 lead ECG. We have different approach to read the ECG, but the best approach in my opinion is 6-step approach, and usually it is applied in our Jazeera University and even the Khartoum University. I think this is someone said the screen not clear. I will share it again. Huh? I will stop the sharing and I will share it again. Okay. Okay, it's clear now.
Yeah, it's clear, yeah, boss.
Okay, we'll proceed. So this six-step approach, adapt yourself in each ECG, you should read it like this. And with time, will not take from you more than 30 to maximally 60. Number one, calculate the rate. Number two, determine the rhythm. Number three, determine the QRS complex axis. Then calculate the intervals, assess the hypertrophy, and look for evidence of infarction and arrhythmia. Regarding the two, determine the rhythm, we'll talk about this in very details in a separate session, which is session three. Look for evidence of infarction, we'll look for it, inshallah, in this next session, inshallah, in a very detailed. In very detailed session. So we'll start to read the ECG. First of all, you should look for the ECG. First, this ECG is belong to your patient or not. You should know the patient is the name and the medical number of the patient is registered on the ECG and it is belong to your patient or not. This number one. Number two, make sure this ECG caliber is right. The caliber usually at the beginning of the QR the ECG paper, which is usually 1 millivolt. If it is less than 1 millivolt, will make a low voltage ECG. If it is more than 1 millivolt, will make the ECG is hypertrophy ECG, which leading to the incorrect interpretation. So make sure for the caliber. I will show you in some ECG where is the caliber is. So let's start with the rate. Usually everyone, I think, know how to calculate the rate. Usually 300. Divide على number of QRS complex. We'll see about this. And Hello.
أيوة يا بوس.
Okay, the rate. I think I am out of the. If the rate, usually you can calculate the rate. You can take two small QRS complex simply, and calculate the large QRS complex. How many boxes in between the QRS complex? This and this one. You can 1, 2, 3. And you can divide it, and I think four small square, large squares. You can divide 300 on the number of the squares between the two large QRS complex, and this is usually simply the rate. But sometimes, usually, in some arrhythmia, the RR interval usually is irregular. So how we can calculate it? By the averaging. Oh, you can take the rhythm strip as you see in this circle, red circle. You can take the rhythm strip and calculate. طبعا, usually it is 50 large square and calculate the QRS complex within this rhythm strip and multiply it by 6 and we do the rate. So, إذا كان regular, if the heart rate is regular, you can calculate the largest large QRS large boxes between the QRS complex and divide 300 over the number of these boxes will give you the rate. Or if it is irregular, you can go to the rhythm strip and calculate the numbers of the QRS complex in the rhythm strip. For example, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And multiplied by 6 will give you the rate. Okay, this is how you calculate the rate. Any problem has anyone has a problem to calculate the rate, or can move on?
Assalamu alaikum.
Salam wa
أقل ستريب ممكن نحسب بيه، وإذا كان irregular rate أقل رزم ممكن نحسب بيه.
ممكن تحسبي مثلا 50 small square، مثلا تحسبي 50 large square وتحسبي الـ QRS complex within الـ 50 large square وتضربيها في 6، أو تحسبي 25 large square وتشوفي الـ QRS complex within the 25 large square وتضربيها في 12 ويطلع لك الـ heart rate.
أوكي.
Any more question in this? أيوة، مرات بيكون مكتوب، نعم الهاريت بيكون مكتوب فوق، لكن usually in the exam أو كذا you should know the rate. Sometimes they would just give you the ECG like this ECG. ما بيكون مكتوب هنا، ما مكتوب. You should know how you can calculate the rate. Not every ECG machine will calculate the rate. Sometimes you should know how you calculate the rate in a correct and in a right way. Okay? Okay, I will make it again. If you have regular rate, يعني معك RR interval is regular. يعني ما في irregularity. That means what I mean. If you look to the QRS complex here, from this QRS complex to this QRS complex equal to this, from here to here, and from here to here. If there is irregularity, sometimes it is difficult to use the usual rule for the calculating the rate, which the usual rule, if the RR interval is equal, or there is no irregularity to calculate the large boxes between the RR. مثلا هي 1 2 3 4 there are four small large square boxes divide 300 over the number of boxes will give you the rate. But sometimes we'll find irregular RR interval. How we can calculate the rate? We can calculate the rate by the go to the rhythm strip. Either تحسب 50 large square 50 large square وتحسب الـ QRS complex within the 50 large square وتضربها في 6، أو مستعجل 25 large square وتضربها الـ QRS complex الموجودة فيها في 12، بتطلع لك الـ heart rate exactly. So this is the way to calculate the rate. So we'll go to the rhythm. The rhythm usually, as we mentioned, when you find is if you look to the rhythm, how we can say the rhythm? The rhythm means look to the B wave. Is it sinus or not? How we can judge it is sinus or not? Look to the configuration of the B wave. Where you can look? Look at the V1 and V2. Okay, you found the B wave. So check, is each B wave followed by QRS complex or not? After that, make the rate is from 60 to 100. After that, you can say this is sinus rhythm. If there is B wave and there is HB wave followed by QRS complex and the rate is less than 60, we can say this is sinus bradycardia. If there is B wave an HB wave followed by the QRS complex. But there is more than 120 sorry, more than 100, we can say this is sinus tachycardia. Arrhythmia, we'll talk about it in a separate session, in a very interesting session, inshallah. Okay, so this is the second step. After the rate, the rhythm. The axis, as you know, everything has axis. The axis, what is the meaning of the axis? Is the direction of the electricity. And the flow of the current within the ventricle. Usually it is goes from up, down. So if we divide it to the angles, this is the heart in the middle, and this is the circle. And this is circle in the up, is negative and down is positive. Then the electricity, once كل ما كانت electricity toward the leads, if the electricity toward the leads will give you positive, what we call the, I need to write something here, but I couldn't. Anyway, if the electricity for the leads will give you positive deflection up, it is away from the leads, electricity go away from the leads will give you negative. As you know, here the electricity started from the SA node down to the ventricle. So down will be a positive here and up will be negative. So electricity, how we can judge this is a normal axis or not? So normal axis usually lies between the minus 30 and positive 90. Any variation here, we can say this is normal axis. Left axis usually from the minus 30 to the minus 90. The right axis, from where? From the minus positive 90 plus 90 to plus 50 and or more. I will make it simple. If you look to this ECG, just look to the V1 and V2. And lead AVF. If all of positive, lead one, lead two, lead three, positive, this is normal axis. Because the electricity is down. As I mentioned before, the electricity comes up from up, down. And the down here, the leads, the inferior leads, is lead one, lead two, and AVF. So electricity toward these leads. If the electricity toward this leads means it is positive. So once it's positive, all of these leads positive, that means the axis normal. Fine. If the leads, if the lead one is positive and lead two is negative, شوي, a little bit negative. And actually, better to mention, it is not lead 2, it is mainly lead AVF is negative. So lead 1 positive, lead AVF or lead 2 negative, يسموها leaving left axis. If lead 1 positive and negative and AVF positive or lead 2 positive, reaching right. So simply, to summarize this, If lead one positive, we lead two positive, normal axis. If lead one positive and lead ABF negative, leaving left. If lead one negative and AVL positive, this reaching right. As you see here, if all of pointing up, normal. If leaving left, if meeting right. Very clear. Anyone has any problem in the axis? He can talk now or silence forever. Hello?
أيوة يا بوس.
Anyone has problem in the access? Oh, I can proceed.
You can proceed.
Okay. The third step in reading ECG, in every ECG, you should read the interval, which are BR interval. Make sure from the BR it's normal or not. QRS complex is the normal duration or not. Then QT interval, very important. As we know, the BR interval normally is from 0.1 to 0.20 seconds, or 120, 120 to 200 milliseconds, or 3 to 5 small square. This is the normal. If it is less than 3 small square, نسميها short BR interval. And we can find it in the Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome, for example. This is one example. Or if it is more than 5 small square, or more than 200 milliseconds, or more than 2.2 seconds, it is usually happened in the blocks, as you see here. If you calculate the BR interval here, from here to here, you will find it. This is 5 small square, and this 2, about 9 small square. Yani it is almost doubling the normal. So prolong BR interval. Okay. Are we good? Okay. Okay. Let us proceed. QRS normal is 0.11 like this. Less than 0.10, it's normal. Usually, if it is more than 0.10, 11, usually يسموها bundle branch block or wide bundle block. طبعا ممكن تلاقيها very wide, based rhythm, تلاقيها في BVC, في bundle branch block, تلاقيها wide QRS complex, as you see in this rhythm strip. The QT interval, as we know, the is less than 0.3, more than 44, which is 0.46 in male, in the female 440, in the female and in the male is more than 460 or 50. If it is prolonged, this this patient is at risk of arrhythmia, serious arrhythmia, and dangerous arrhythmia, which is polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. Or we can call it torsa de bois, as you said in this rhythm. This is polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. Inshallah, we'll talk it about it in a little bit detail in a arrhythmia session. And we are approaching. If you look to the hypertrophy, as we know, we have four chambers. We have right atrium, we have left atrium, we have right ventricle, we have left ventricle. How we can make sure we have no problem in the hypertrophy? In the right atrium, we can, the ECG can reflect there is hypertrophy or enlargement of the right atrium by looking to the B wave, which represent the atrial depolarization. If the B wave is peak, more than 2.5 millimole, okay, in the lead two, and in more than 1.5 millimole, or millimeter, it's not millimole, it is millimeter. The B wave more than 2.5 millimeter in the two limb leads, which usually E2, and in the chest leads, usually V1, more than 1.5 millimeter. This is what we call right atrial enlargement or right atrial hypertrophy. Look at this. Look at this in this ECG. Look at the lead 2. Usually, very huge B wave, almost 2/3 of the QRS complex. So it is peak. So we call it a right atrial enlargement, peak B wave. Okay. We have a lot of causes for this, but at least you know how we can pick up the we can diagnose the right atrial enlargement from the ECG. And the B wave here is about more than 2.5 millimeter in up, okay? And if you look to the V1, if it is more than 1.5 millimeter up, so this is what we call B pulmonal, P pulmonal, or peaked B wave, which indicate right atrial enlargement. Anyone has problem in this, I can move on. Clear, okay, good. طيب. Regarding the left, as you know, the B wave reflect both left right atrium and left atrium. Okay. The first part of the B wave, it is by the right atrium, and the second half of the B wave is by the left atrium. If the left atrium is hypertrophied, that means we need time to depolarize the left atrium. So the B wave will be very broad. We call فيها a bifid B wave. Bifid B wave. If you look to the lead 2 here, bifid B wave. It is not peak. If it is peak, that's mean right atrium. Is bifid, that's mean left atrial enlargement. And as we know from before, you look for the B wave in the lead 2 and V1. Here, there is notch or bifid B wave here in the lead 2, and in V1 we'll find the negative deflection more than positive deflection. So this is left atrial enlargement. If you compare it to the normal here, the B wave, look at this small beautiful B wave, and here it is bifid B wave, and here the B wave is biphasic, and here more negative than positive in V1. So this is what we call bifid B wave or B mitral, which indicates left atrial enlargement. Here, it is B pulmonal, which indicates right atrial enlargement. The B wave in E2 and V1. Positive, prominent positive, more than 2.5, and positive in V1 more than 1.5 P pulmonal, and negative or bifid in the B lead 2 and bifid B wave in lead 2 and morely negative in the V1, it is a left atrial enlargement. Is it clear or I can repeat it until morning? Is it clear or can I go or we can move on? Okay. طيب. So we have right atrium, left atrium. Then we'll go to the right ventricle. Right ventricle, usually the normal, the right ventricle is reflected, looked by the V1. Usually there is small R, as you see here. When there is right ventricular hypertrophy, you will find a very dominant R wave. Very dominant R wave here, as you said, very dominant R wave. And you will find ST segment depression V2, V3. سموها strain pattern. Something heavy on the right ventricle makes the ST segment to go down. So, very dominant R wave. So, when you find there is dominant R wave in the V1 with ST segment depression, this is indicate right ventricular hypertrophy. Although there is other causes of dominant R and V1, most important, we'll discuss it now, but the one of the causes of the dominant R wave in V1 with ST segment depression like this is right ventricular hypertrophy. What are the criteria of right ventricular hypertrophy? Right criteria of right ventricular hypertrophy, تلاقي right axis deviation. Look at the V1 and VAVF. Positive lead to positive, and this is negative. Reaching right. So right axis deviation. This is the criteria. Plus dominant R in V1 more than the R in V1 more than 7 millimeter. If it is R wave in the V1 more than 7 millimeter, and there is right axis deviation, this is indicate right ventricular hypertrophy. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yeah, it's clear, yeah, boss.
My screen is clear for everybody, because someone said your screen not clear.
واضح الاسكرين.
So, okay.
واضح
so,
جدا.
Okay, so if we find right axis deviation, as we see in this ECG, with dominant R in V1, and the R is more than 7 millimeter, is called right ventricular hypertrophy. Okay, so the last hypertrophy is left ventricular hypertrophy. The left ventricle seen by the lateral leads, which is a V5 and V6. Okay, so the criteria of the left ventricular hypertrophy, so many criteria, a lot of criteria. I will not mention all of these criteria, but I mentioned two criteria here. If you understand it, it's enough. That one of these criteria, if you look to the AVL, in the AVL, if you find the R wave in the AVL more than 13 millimeter, this is left ventricular hypertrophy. If you calculate it here, you know, from here to here is almost 14 or 15 millimeter. So it is left ventricular hypertrophy. The other criteria, as I mentioned here, calculate the R wave here in the V6 or V5, and usually pick the tallest one. Usually here the tallest one is 5. And add it to the deepest S in the V1 or V2. If it is more than 35 millimeter, this is left ventricular hypertrophy. Let us calculate here. Here, if you calculate, here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5 square, which is usually 25 millimeter. Okay. Let us go to the V2, the S, 1, 2, and 1/2. So 10 plus 2, 12, okay? And plus 12 plus 25, almost 37. So more than 35, this is what we call Sokolov criteria. No need to mention the name, but usually this is that way. So either AVL in the R wave in AVL more than 13 millimeter, or you can calculate the R in the V5, and you can add it to the S in V2. If it is more than 3 millimeter, 5 millimeter, this is left ventricular hypertrophy. clear or I can repeat? Okay. The left ventricular hypertrophy, usually the left ventricle is locked by the leads, which are from here. If you look to these leads here, yeah, if this is the left ventricle, this is the heart, this is the left ventricle. Left ventricle laterally, which looked by 5, 6 lead 1 and ABL. Any leads from these can reflect what's happening in the left ventricle. If there is any dominant of muscles, that's mean the electricity will go more at that part. That's mean there is high voltage. That's mean there is hypertrophy. How we can pick it up? You can calculate the dominant R in the 5 or 6 plus the dominant S, العكس. العكس, on the opposite side, the dominant S in the V2 or V1, if it is more than 35 millimeter, is called left ventricular hypertrophy. Or you can pick up AVL and calculate the R wave. If it is more than 13 millimeter, this is left ventricular hypertrophy. I will make it clear again in this slide. I will calculate it again in this. If you look here, they pick up the 5, the R in V5. The R is about 25 millimeter. They add it to the S in V2 or V1, which is almost 30 millimeter. They collect it together. I found it more than 35 millimeter. This is criteria of left ventricular hypertrophy. Or they can calculate the R in the AVL, which is almost more than 13 millimeter, which is indicate left ventricular hypertrophy. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So this is okay. Good. So this is about at the end of our first session, which is how you read the ECG. This is a very boring session. But the next session, which is ischemia, and very interesting session is arrhythmia, very exciting session, will be very excited. So this is actually, it is very boring, sorry for that, and my apology for that. But it is necessary to go over these things, because it's very important session. If you allow me, I will take 5 to 10 minutes if you allow me to conclude the session. If you allow me, I can proceed. If not, I will stop here. Okay. Can I proceed or can I stop here? No problem. I need just 10 minutes. Okay, I will conclude. This is actually conclusion of our sessions. Okay, good. Okay, good. Proceed. Okay, I will take from your time 10 minutes maximum, inshallah. Okay. I need someone. I will help him to read this ECG. I have ECG. I need to go through it to see are we okay with this session or not. can anyone help me? I will go with to read this. Please, this will take times. This silence will take times. I need someone to help me to start. Hello? Hello?
اتفضلي يا ماجدة. You can unmute yourself.
It is actually, it is not to this not to impress anyone. This is just to to make it interactive session. It's not just for embracing anyone at all. Can anyone help me here? Already talked 5 minutes in this.
اتفضلي يا ماجدة، رفع يدك. اتفضلي.
I don't know. سامح، the screen is not clear. Someone said the screen is not clear.
It's clear.
Okay. So okay. I will start myself. I will talk to myself to initiate the people. So usually in the ECG, look at this ECG. Just make sure this ECG is belong to your patient. Make sure from the name and medical number of the patient, and then make sure from the caliber. This is the caliber what I am talking about before. You make sure this is the one is the caliber. Is this 1 millivolt or not? If it is more than this, will give you hypertrophy, pseudo-hypertrophy. If it is less than this, will give you low voltage. So make sure your caliber is okay. After that, go through the six approach steps as we discuss it now. I will just mention some points. We already discussed it now. The arrhythmia and ischemia, we'll discuss it in the separate sessions, inshallah. So I will start this ECG. I will calculate the rate. Actually, it is the QRS complex. It is looks regular. So I will calculate the QRS large square between this 1, 2, 3, 4. So 100 over 300 over 4, about 75 millimeter beat per minute. So I then after that, I will make sure from that. If I look for the B wave in the lead two, this is there is B wave, beautiful B wave, no problem. Sorry. It is biphasic in the V1, so it is sinus and HB wave followed by QRS complex. And the rate is about 75, so this is sinus rhythm. So the third step to check the axis. I will look to the axis, the lead one and lead two, leaving left, reaching right, all on positive. It is normal axis. This lead one, lead two, as well as AVF. So positive up, negative this down. So we can lift axis deviation. After that, we can mention interval. BR interval usually it is about 4 millimeter. QT interval is the normal. QRS complex is the normal. Step three, if there is hypertrophy, I will check the atrial hypertrophy. Look to the B wave. It is a little bit. We can say this is borderline right atrial alignment. It is negative mainly in the V1, but we can not make sure from this. There is a B wave, R wave in the V1 not dominant, so there is no right atrial, right ventricular hypertrophy. We'll check that if there is any left ventricular hypertrophy. Here we can calculate the 5 or 6. The large is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and the deepest is 1, 2. It is 4 with 2. It's 6. 6 by 5 is 30. So it is not hypertrophy. So we can say this is a normal ECG with left axis deviation, normal sinus rhythm. Simply, simple as that. طبعا should check if there is any arrhythmia or if there is any evidence of infarction will be discussed in a separate session. So anyone can help me in this ECG? Hello? Okay, I think maybe the session is so long and takes from your time a long time. So I will just conclude here. I will go through this ECG. If you look to the ECG, it is, as well as mentioned, make sure from the name, blah, 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 and make sure that the caliber is, and then calculate the rate is almost 60. Here, five large square, because it's regular. And there is BF, and the BF is okay. ما في مشكلة. There is no right atrial hypertrophy. But if you look to the V1, it's very dominant R, very dominant R. So this is likely a right ventricular hypertrophy. If you look to interval, BR interval is okay. And if you look to the QRS complex a little bit wide, when you look to the wide QRS complex, when could be bundle branch block, could be BBC, could be based rhythm. Here you can make sure from this in the V1 and V6, you can see this RSR pattern. We'll discuss inshallah ta'ala in the how we can recognize the right bundle branch block from the left bundle branch block. Don't be worried about this. So this is right bundle branch block with right ventricular hypertrophy. Okay. The answer is there. If you look to this ECG, one I told you, if you look to the V1, you can find the B wave is negative. Look at this, it is negative. صح ولا لا؟ Negative. And there is dominant R wave in the V1. But if you look to the progression of the from V1 to V6, it is looks reversed. Usually, in the V1, the R wave is small, and will go down to the V6 will be large. Here reversed, and the B wave is negative in the lead one, and this is this situation either dextrocardia or the leads is reversed. How we can differentiate in dextrocardia? Look at the precordial leads. From V2, V3, V5. If it is the progression is reversed with negative B negative B or lead one, this is likely dextrocardia, as you mentioned, and this is the patient's X-ray, the heart on the right, the right side. And this gentleman, if you look E1, you will find the B wave is negative. Okay, that means either dextrocardia or gunna a or lead or the lead is mal replaced or mal displaced or the lead placement or the lead is not in the right position. To طالع وين, look at the V1, V2, V6. V1, V2, V6, V3. If you look to the V1, it's normal progression, but the lead one, there is negative B wave. This is likely lead replacement. The lead is replaced. ما بين ال حتى if you look to the AVR, and قلنا في normal, all of the waves of the AVR should be negative. لكن هنا positive. وهذه كل الويفز نيجاتيف وشود بي بوزيتيف. سو ذيس از ريبليس ما بين الاي في ار اند ليد 1. ذيس از هاو يو ديفرنشيت بتوين ليد ريبليسمنت اند ديكستروكارديا. ديكستروكارديا from V1 to V6, the progression of the R wave reversed from the V6 to V1. But in the lead replacement, the progression of the R wave is okay. ما في مشكلة. But the problem is a negative lead one B wave in the lead one and the positive B in the AVR. So this is I check this is the end of our session tonight. Inshallah, we'll discuss more about this ECG. I will, if you are interested, I will send a practical session. You can train yourself and you can send me the answers. I will can correct it again to make sure you are understand the session. This is my starting point in Wad Madani Cardiac Center. It is very nice period I spent there. This is my starting point there. I start to learn and to practice cardiology in this amazing and amazing center. Inshallah, I'm going to in ahead of the centers in the Middle East and even in the world. Abuji, for my delay today. So I'm sorry for what's happening today of the delay, and I'm sorry for this. I talk almost 1 hour and 40 minutes. 1 hour and 40 minutes. Sorry for that. If any questions, I am ready to answer. If not, you can. We can say good night, inshallah.
الله يجزيك الخير دكتور الصالح البصيري في ميزان حسناتك. إن شاء الله المحاضرة كانت واضحة جدا. لو في أي زول عنده أي سؤال أو أي كومنت يا أخواننا ممكن يكتب في الشات أو في الفيس, ونلتقي في بعد في الأيام الجاية إن شاء الله في سيشن تاني في نفس الموضوع بإذن الله. إن شاء الله ربنا يجعله في ميزان حسناتك وحسناتكم, وشكرا على صبركم وحسن استماعكم, وبارك الله فيكم.
ما في مشكلة, استودعكم الله, نشوفكم على خير. Oh, no problem, anything, any sessions you want in the cardiology, you are very welcome, inshallah. The second session will be arranged with Dr. Samah, and the announcement will be with you in a good, يعني, in a very, very, in a good time, inshallah. It is good for me and for you, inshallah. Thank you very much.
Inshallah, بإذن الله. السلام.